Okay, good morning, or good afternoon, whenever you're watching this. I'm going to quick go through the answers to your assignment from yesterday. So, hopefully, what you guys can do is like watch this and pull up Notability, like split screen, so you can check your work. Okay, so number one says which graph represents the following situation? A car accelerates, then travels at a constant speed. So, hopefully, you chose B for this because you can see that it accelerates and then it's at a constant speed over time. Question two, find the slope. What does it mean with the context? Okay, so if I'm looking for the slope here, I'm going to see, all right, well, how much do I add each time? And it looks like I'm adding 14 each time, right? So that's going to be 14 over 1, so that's good. I can cross out C and D. And we've got number of students, total cost in dollars. So this is how much they make per student. So it looks like that's the amount charged in dollars per student, right? Because it starts at 98, so then every time they add, it's 14. So you should have chosen A for number two. Number three, water consumption. I told you guys if you're drinking a lot of water, what might the temperature be outside? So hopefully you chose positive, right? It would be a positive relationship, and it should be linear, right? We should be able to see like a definitely a trend going across that graph. All right, let's look at question four. It says, what is the initial value of the trend line that shows how many sit-ups Tim completes each minute? And so I gave you the clue. Initial value means where does the trend line start? So our y-intercept is our initial value, so we would say 0, 0 is our answer there because if he hasn't started, he hasn't done any sit-ups, so that's why that would be our initial value. Number five, what is the rate of change of the trend line that shows how many sit-ups Tim completes each minute? So what I did here, I'm going to zoom in a little bit. I found two perfect intersection points, so I'm going to use this one. That looks like a perfect intersection point. And maybe this one right here, right? So then when I do my slope, I go, these are by tens, right? So 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, up 70, and then over 1 minute, 2 minutes, 3 minutes, 4 minutes. So I would get 70 over 4, which we talked about, like, let's just try to simplify that to something easy. So I might say that this was 80 over 4. I might estimate that. And maybe that's what you guys got, was 80 over 4, which then, of course, simplifies to 20 sit-ups every minute, right? So he's moving. Write the equation that could be used to describe the trend line. So I'm on number 6 now. So I told you to use the initial value, that's our y-intercept from problem 4, and the slope from problem 5. So hopefully you had y equals 20x plus 0, which we all know we don't have to write the plus 0. So y equals, oops, 20x. Okay, so we can estimate based on our trend line that he's going to do about 20 sit-ups per minute. Okay, so now down here for number 7, it says use the equation, the line of best fit, to predict how many sit-ups he can do in 8 minutes. Okay, well, let's write out our equation, y equals 20x. We know that x is the minutes because that's the title of my x-axis, and y is the sit-ups, which I gotta be honest, I hate sit-ups, just saying. So if I'm gonna put 8 in here for x, so y equals 20 times 8, so y equals 160 sit-ups. Yikes, who wants to do that? Okay, so that's number 7. And then we skipped a couple cards. Now we're on number 11 here. So it says describe the correlation as positive, negative, or no correlation. So they drew a trend line. Probably what happened is this is a lot of data, so you would be able to see more of that trend. So we're going to say positive. Okay, and we could say linear because I want to believe that if I were to zoom out, there's tons of those dots expanding in both directions. Okay. So that one may not have been as obvious, but that's what your answer should be. Number 12, which of the three lines shown is the best line of fit? Explain your reasoning. So for number 12, you should have said line 2 because it's as close to as many as possible. Line 3 is a hard no, right? And I know that these are colored on yours, so I don't know what colors they are because when I print this, of course, there's no color showing up. But hopefully you said line 2 because it is as close to as many points as possible. Right? Even line 1 is kind of wonky, but line 2 definitely is going with as many points as possible. Okay, number 14, identify the relationship as positive, negative, or no correlation. Okay, so I gave you guys the hint to picture this data on a graph. So if I were to draw a graph of this, right? So the more miles you drive, the less gas in your tank, right? So this would be gas, and this would be miles. Okay? So if you think about it, when I get in my car and I'm driving, I think I have that switched. I do. This should be miles, and this should be gas. Okay, so let's say I just filled up my tank and I'm going on a road trip. So I start out here with a full tank, and then of course as I drive, the further I go, the less gas I have in my tank, right? And so then of course I have to pull over, get more gas, go to the bathroom, get a bottle of water, maybe some peanut M&Ms, what have you. So you should have said negative. And of course it's going to be linear because you're probably driving about the same speed the whole time, right? So, I mean, maybe it's a little bit different, but this is what it should look like. Okay, let's look at 15 here. Identify the relationship as positive, negative, or no correlation. So the number of passengers on a plane and the amount of luggage that has to be loaded. Okay, so this, you could definitely like overthink this, but it's supposed to be pretty straightforward, right? Passengers. Oops, that's supposed to be an E. Passengers and suitcases, right? So theoretically, the more passengers you have, the more suitcases, right? Not to say that one person can't bring one and another person brings like five. I don't know how bad you pack. But either way, the more passengers, the more suitcases you're going to have. So this would be a positive. And then our form would be linear. So direction is positive, form is linear. Okay, moving right along. Here on the back we have number 16. The number of ice creams sold in July and the number of people who swim in pools. Okay, this one's a little bit more abstract, I'm going to be honest. But I'm going to draw a graph. Okay, and I think what they're going for here is here's ice creams, and here's the number of people in a pool, right? I think what the connection they're trying to make is like it's hot, right, because it's July. So probably as you're selling more ice creams, there's more people in pools because it's hot. Okay, so you would have had a positive linear. And I realize some of you are probably thinking, I could totally argue it differently, and you could, but this isn't about like, you know, it's just like in general, more people are eating ice cream because it's hot, as well as going in the pool because it's hot. Okay, and I know there's people out there that like, I never go to the pool. That's fine. But, you know, we're going by the generic understandings. All right, number 17. Which of the three lines shown is line of best fit? Explain your reasoning. And then it says, for real, explain your reasoning. Because I know some of you are like, oh. Okay, we know it's not one. Right? That's terrible. That's just a horizontal line. That's not going to be it. In line 3 seems like it's really close up here to the top. So we're going to go line 2 being the one that's the closest. I think it was line 2 last time. And then we would say because it is as close to as many points as possible. Right, because that is our goal after all. Okay. Number 18 is another refresher on functions. Which of the following situations corresponds to this graph? Okay, so what I see happening here is that someone is speeding up and then constant rate and then slowing down. So let's see if we have anything. Sam gradually accelerated his car to 50 miles per hour from a stop, set his cruise control and travel at a constant speed, then slowed to stop. That could be it. So A is a contender. Sam accelerated his car to 50 miles per hour from a stop, stopped at a gas station. Nope. If he stopped at a gas station, he would have gone right back down to no speed. So B is a no. Sam accelerated his car to 50 miles per hour from a stop, slowed to 30, then accelerated. No, that would be like up, down, up. Sam slowed his car down from 50 miles to 20 miles. Well, we know that's not it because if he slowed his car down, he would have been up here at his speed and he would have gone down. So I think we're going to have to say it's a solid A. That should have been your answer. Number 19, to ride on go-karts at Rick's Play Zone, it costs $4 per ride plus $3 to rent the helmet. The total cost Y in dollars depends on X number of times you ride the go-karts, right? An equation. This is easy, right? Remember, we have our repeating fee, so that's going to be our slope, and we have our one-time fee just to rent the helmet. That's going to be my y-intercept. So hopefully you got Y equals 4X plus 3. Fingers crossed. Okay, like I said, easy peasy. All right, moving right along. We're on number 21. I think this is the last four problems. All right, which pair of variables would best fit the scatter plot above? Okay, so we're going to look and see if this matches. Age of a tadpole and the length of their tail. So I don't know a whole lot about tadpoles, but I'm pretty sure their tail disappears, right? So the age could be increasing and the tail could be decreasing. So A could be it. Average temperature and the number of coats sold. So I'm guessing if coats was down here, if the temperature is going up or going down, you're probably going to sell more coats. So maybe temperature is down here, coats is here. I don't think B is it. I think B should be a positive relationship. The amount of clothes purchased and the amount of money left in a person's wallet. Well, I don't know. I mean, you're going to have less money, but this would be less purchasing as well. So I don't think it's going to be C. A person's height and their math grade. Nope, that definitely does not have a relationship. I'm sorry. I hate to break it to you tall people. Doesn't mean you're getting an A. So again, our answer is going to be A for 21. 22, what does the slope of the graph represent? All right, so let me zoom in here. We've got number of games and what is this? Oh, and the cost, because we're bowling. Okay, so our slope is going to represent the cost per game that you play, right? So we can look here and we can say, all right, well, it's probably $6 per game because it goes up 6 over 1, up 6 over 1, up 6 over 1. So the total cost to bowl decreases. No. Come on now. That's not a decreasing graph. That's not real. The number of games bowled decreased by $6 for 6 for every dollar spent. No. The number of games bowled increased by 1 for every $6. There we go. Right, so we could see that it cost, and then the total cost spent increases by 6 for every game bowled. I mean, I guess D could be an answer too, because it is increasing. We'll say C and D. If you put D, I'll take it. I think that's one that like maybe has caught people, like confused people in the past. All right, what does the y-intercept of the graph represent? Okay, you really should not have needed help on this. So it's at 0, 0. So after bowling 0 games, you will spend $0. I think that's pretty obvious, right? If you haven't bowled, you haven't spent anything. And it doesn't look like maybe this bowling alley charges anything for a shoe rental. And number 24, the scatter plot compares the hours of time players spend practicing baseball and the number of hits missed during games. If a player spent 5 hours practicing baseball, which would be the best prediction of how many hits they would miss? So let's go over to 5 hours of baseball. Maybe they would miss 40 hits, and that's not even an option here. So hopefully you saw that that wasn't an option. I can't believe I wrote you got this because you don't got this because the answer is not there. Oh my gosh. So the answer here should have been 40, right? 5 hours practicing baseball. How many hits would they miss? Yeah, man, why would they have 10, 30, 50, 70? Nope. Okay, well, the answer there was 40. I apologize for the confusion. All right, so hopefully you have all the right answers, and now I'm going to make sure you have the study guide for the quiz the next time I see you. Thanks, guys.